but if we're targeting this area.
Just 1 month short of 1 year since the worst disaster in its history, Sonoma County threw open its doors for the first test of a new wireless emergency alert system in full public view. Officials were betting what's learned, warts and all, will make Sonoma County a model for emergency response.
You know, last year in Sonoma County, we had a lot of concern and a lot of issues and a lot of criticism about how we managed emergency alert. And we got to own that. We got to own that moment and make sure that we're resilient for our community. So that's what we're doing right now. We're pushing the bar. And we are anticipating it's going to be bumpy because we need to find the gaps in the system.
Getting it right is key. The county's emergency response last October was widely reviewed and parts of it criticized, resulting in a reorganization of emergency services in the county to make it more responsive to elected officials and fast-moving events.
Our experiences here in Sonoma County in the fires of October 2017 triggered a national conversation, actually changed the way the federal government is asking technology providers to support alert and warning. And here in the state of California, even as recently as last month with our experiences in fires in Northern California, that move towards increasing capabilities for alert and warning is only gaining momentum.
Texts were sent from the operations center to more than 20,000 cell phones in five geographically targeted locations across the county, asking the public to respond. Within minutes, real-time monitoring showed web traffic taking off as users completed surveys online.
With real-time information on the board, you can see who is getting the information and who is not. So that is exciting in itself because that tells us how the system is working.
There's a survey that we'd like people to complete.
Meantime, a phone bank responded to questions from the public. Within an hour, officials were ready to share their first impressions, the good as well as what needed work.
What did we see here today, first of all? Well, we're in the preliminary phases of finding out what this data really means. But the first thing we can say is all three of these systems worked. But there was significant spillover we can see already where we targeted a specific area, for instance, in Sonoma Valley, and people got notifications in Petaluma, Rohnert Park, and other areas.
What I have been hearing from my constituents is that they did not actually receive the cell phone notification. I called Russian River Fire Department. Not a single staffer or person on site at the Russian River Fire Department received a notification via cell phone. But the good news is that's exactly why we run this test.
Wireless alerts rely on different cell providers, phone technologies, and physical geographies to reach their target, a complex and evolving system. Managers here are the first to say this first test of the SoCo Alert and wireless emergency alert systems was a learning experience. Online surveys and real-time feedback from 50 carefully placed observers will determine how the county moves forward.
Clearly, the public has significant expectations of government when it comes to alert and warning. Clearly, we're going to have to be able to deliver on those expectations, not only at the local level, but also through the federal government as well.
In the end, this is all about results, taking the lessons learned today, both good and bad, and applying them to the future. The first official word on what happened today and what we've learned will come before the Board of Supervisors the first week of October. In Sonoma County, Carl Van Amburg for News of the North Bay.